हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 5, दैट इज लाइट एनर्जी। फर्स्ट पॉइंट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज रिफ्रैक्शन। व्हेन लाइट ट्रेवल्स फ्रॉम वन मीडियम टू अदर, इट बेंड्स फ्रॉम इट्स ओरिजिनल डायरेक्शन, दिस इज कॉल्ड रिफ्रैक्शन। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, सपोज लाइट इज ट्रेवलिंग इन एयर एंड एंटर्स वाटर, और लाइट इज ट्रेवलिंग इन एयर एंटर्स सम ग्लास पीस, ग्लास स्लैब। लाइट चेंजेस इट्स डायरेक्शन ऑफ मोशन, दिस इज कॉल्ड रिफ्रैक्शन। नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाई रिफ्रैक्शन टेक्स प्लेस। रिफ्रैक्शन टेक्स प्लेस बिकॉज स्पीड ऑफ लाइट इज डिफरेंट इन डिफरेंट मीडिया। द मीडियम इन विच स्पीड ऑफ लाइट इज मोर is called bearer medium, for example air or vacuum, and the medium in which speed of light is less is called denser medium, for example water and glass. For your information I tell you, speed of light in vacuum is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, while speed of light in water 2.25 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Speed of light in glass is 2 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. By these data, you can easily understand that speed of light is maximum in vacuum and comparatively less in water and glass. So water and glass are denser medium with respect to vacuum or air. So when light travels from one medium to other, it bends from original direction of motion and it is called refraction. Let us understand some terminology. Suppose XY is refracting surface, you can understand one medium, second medium. Here we are taking first medium as rarer medium like air, and second medium a denser medium like water or glass. A beam of light AP incidents on this surface. Dotted line shows original direction of propagation of light, but when light enters second medium, it will bend towards the normal. This is normal, means this line is making 90 degree with surface XY. So when light travels from rarer medium to denser medium, it bends towards normal. In second figure, first medium is denser medium like water or glass, and second medium is rarer medium like air. Ray incidence, this is the original direction of propagation. Now the ray moves away from the normal. When light travels from rarer to denser medium, it bends towards normal. While traveling from denser to rarer medium, it bends away from the normal. AP is incident ray, PB is refracted ray, MN is normal. This is line making 90 degree with surface XY. Angle between incident ray and normal. Angle between incident ray and normal is called angle of incidence, while angle between refracted ray and normal is called angle of refraction. Details are written there. Students, next topic is laws of refraction and refractive index. There are two laws of refraction. First law says that incident ray, reflected ray and normal lie in same plane. See, this is plane of board. Board is a plane, and very clearly incident ray, is situated in plane of board, normal situated in plane of board, refracted ray situated in plane of board. Therefore, incident ray, normal and refracted ray lie in same plane. Second law says that sin I upon sin R, it is spelled as sin, not sin. Sin I upon sin R is equal to constant, and this constant is called refractive index. In fact, sin is a trigonometrical ratio. You will study in class 9th and higher classes. You need not bother too much about this sign. Only you have to learn that sin I upon sin R is a constant, and this constant is called refractive index. Refractive index determines amount of deviation. Suppose refractive index of this medium is less, so this deviation will be less. This is deviation from original propagation. And if refractive index of this medium is more, so this deviation will be more. Refractive index can also be represented in terms of speed of light. Speed of light in air or vacuum upon speed of light in medium. Suppose you want to know refractive index of this medium. And first medium is air. Suppose it is glass and it is air. So refractive index of this medium, that is glass in this example, can be calculated with the help of this formula. Speed of light in air upon speed of light in medium. Suppose you are going to find refractive index of glass. So you have to take speed of light in air upon speed of light in glass. Though there are many effects of refraction in our daily life, one very common example, very common effect is given in your book, that is bending of pencil or any stick when dipped in water. You might have seen. Try to understand this effect of refraction by this ray diagram. Suppose this is pencil from the tip of the pencil a ray comes. It is water, it is air, so ray is traveling from water to air, that is denser to rarer medium. Students, I just told that when ray travels from denser to rarer medium, it bends away from the normal. So this is original direction of propagation, but it will bend away from the normal. This line is normal, so it will go somewhat like this. If some observer is present here, then it appears that this ray is coming from this point. So this ray is coming from this point. You produce this ray behind, so ray meets here. So it appears that ray is coming from this point. So tip of the pencil is seen here. Very clearly, the pencil will look bent. So bending of pencil in water or any denser medium is because of refraction, as it is very clear in the diagram. स्टूडेंट्स, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज रिफ्रैक्शन थ्रू ग्लास स्लैब. सपोज इट इज अ ग्लास स्लैब, रेक्टेंगुलर ग्लास स्लैब, अरे इंसिडेंट्स. सपोज फर्स्ट मीडियम इज एयर, ऑब्वियसली इट इज मेड ऑफ ग्लास. रे इंसिडेंट्स, रेज ट्रेवलिंग फ्रॉम रेरर टू डेंसर मीडियम, सो इट विल बेंड टुवर्ड्स नॉर्मल. This is the original course of the ray. If there was no glass slab, the ray would have gone in this direction. This direction. So this is direction of incident ray. But the ray bends towards the normal. This is refracted ray. PQ is refracted ray. At point Q, again medium is going to change, but in opposite sense. Opposite sense means now the ray is traveling from denser to rarer medium. The ray would have gone in this direction. See this dotted line. The ray would have gone in this direction. But traveling from denser to rarer medium, so it will bend away from the normal. And if these two faces are parallel, this emergent ray, ray QB is called emergent ray. This ray is found to be parallel to the incident ray. Means the emergent ray suffers some displacement from original direction of propagation. And this gap is called lateral displacement. So this is refraction through glass slab. I repeat, ray traveling from air to glass means rarer to denser medium. Bends towards normal. Here it is traveling from denser to rarer, so bends away from the normal. So emergent ray is found to be parallel to the incident ray. Getting? So this is refraction through glass slab. Separation between emergent ray and incident ray is called lateral displacement. I suppose students could understand. Thank you students for paying attention. Keep studying. God bless you.